open your literacy textbook to page number 142. Okay. Our topic is a picture story. They have given you some picture and they have created a story along with the picture. And in the story, they have missed out some words. Some words are missing. Instead of those words, they have given you pictures. Using these pictures, you have to complete the story. Okay? So in the left hand corner, write today's date. That is 1st February. Yesterday was 31st Jan. Yesterday the January month has been ended. A new month has been started. That is 1st February 2021. And in the middle of the page, write CW. Okay? We'll read out the story first. Okay? And then later, I'll tell you which words are missing. You can write it out. It was winter. Winter ka mausam tha, thandi ka mausam tha. Full stop. Sentence has been completed. This dot it means full stop. That means the sentence has been completed. Okay. One day the dash. The word is missing, but they have drawn something. What they have drawn? Sun. One day the sun was shining brightly. So on top of the picture sun, write the spelling S U N sun. Here you write S U N sun. Okay. Full stop. Now, here they have given you pictures instead of the name. Who is she? Mama, Papa, my sister. So, next line you write Mama or you can write Mummy. When you turn the page to page 143, here are the spellings. You can see them and write Mama, Papa and my sister she is. Okay? On top of the picture, here they have drawn Mama's face. So on top of this you write Mama. Here is Papa's face and here is sister's face. Right? So Mama, Papa, Mummy, Papa, my sister and I went to the, what is this? Zoo. They have given it here. So next on the picture of the zoo, right? Z-O-O, zoo. Full stop. A dash was moving, running about. What is this? Deer. If you don't know the spelling of the deer, here it is. On the next page. D-E-E-R. Deer. Deer. Okay? Sorry. Write it in cursive handwriting. You write it in cursive handwriting. We saw two pictures have been given. What is that? Elephant. They saw two elephants. We saw two elephants and a, what is that? Monkey. What did they say? Two elephants and the monkey. Okay. The dash was swinging from a dash. What is this? Which picture is this? Who is swinging on it? On that monkey. Okay. After the, there is a picture of the monkey. So write the spelling of monkey. Was swinging from a tree. The picture of the, the picture is T-R-E-E, tree, full stop. The sentence has been ended. A dash was resting on the picture. Who is this? Tiger. It is our national animal. T-I-G-E-R. Tiger was resting on the grass. G-R-A-S-S. Grass. A tiger was resting on the grass. On top of this only you write the names. On top of this only you write the words. Okay. Next. Now next. My dash. Who is she? My sister. So here you write. My sister was happy to see the, which national bird is this? Peacock. So on top of that write peacock. P-E-A-C-O-C-K. On page 143, now the spellings have been given. You can utilize the spellings, spellings if you don't know. Peacock, full stop. There were some, which picture is this? Which animal is this? Ducks. There were some ducks too, full stop. We had fun, exclamation mark. Next day, dusre day, I went to my, who is this? Dada Dadi. Who are they? Grandma, Grandpa. Grandma is a lady, Dadi, and Grandpa is the James, that is Dadaji. Okay? Z-O-O, zoo. I will show you how to write, okay? Take your pencil and you can write. So what is today's date? Now look in the book and write along with me. Today's date is 1st February. And CW, read out the picture story along with me. It was winter, full stop, thandi ka mausam tha. One day, which picture is this? Sun. So right here is S-U-N. The sun was shining brightly. Now who is she? Mummy. After brightly, there's a full stop. Comma, Papa, my sister. S-I-S-T-E-R. And I went to the, what is this? Z-O-O, zoo. They have given you full stop. Which animal is this? Deer. Deer was running about. Full stop. Deer kya kar raha tha zoo mein? Ghoom raha tha. Now there's a girl who is telling you about her visit. She is telling you a story that one Sunday she had been somewhere. It was winter. Thandi ke mausam mein. Ek din dhoop aayi thi. To mummy, papa, uski behan aur wo kahan gaye the? Zoo ghoomne gaye the. Zoo mein enter karne ke baad usne pehla animal kaun sa dekha? Deer. Yahan wahan bhag raha tha. Then what did they see? We saw two elephants. What are these? Elephants. And a monkey. What did they see? Elephants and monkey. Full stop. Which animal is this? Monkey. Where does a monkey live? On the tree. Was swinging from a tree. Full stop. Which animal? Tiger. Tiger was resting on the grass. Now, her sister, the girl's, who is she? Sister. The girl ki choti behan jo hai, she was very happy to see. Which animal is this? Peacock. Our national bird it is. Sorry, not animal. It is our national bird. There were some, what are these? Ducks too. We had fun. Seeing all the animals in the zoo, the whole family had lots of fun. Next day, okay. After that, after they came back home, the very next day they went to their grandma and grandpa's house. Where did they go to meet? Grandma and grandpa. Dada, dadi aur dada ke ghar gaye the. What did the girl and her sister tell? I told them about our visit to the zoo. Dadi aur dada ko usne kya bola? Where they had been visit to the zoo. Okay. Now this picture story has been completed. We will write once in our notebook today. Open your English notebook. Keep your English textbook in front of you and write along with me. Keep your English textbook in front of you and write along with me. Write today's date in your English notebook. A picture story, okay? Start writing with me. It was winter. One day, full stop. That means the sentence is complete. Write along seeing the textbook itself. The sun was shining brightly. S-H-I-N-I-N-G. Shining. B-R-I-G-H-T-L-Y. Brightly. Who are they? Full stop. Sentence complete. Mummy. Papa. My sister. And I went to the, where did they go? Went to the zoo. What did they see? Which animal did they see first? A deer was running about. We saw two elephants. And a monkey. The monkey was swinging from a tree. The next paragraph will continue tomorrow. Okay. After this, open your GK textbook. Open your GK textbook to page number 99. Okay. We will learn GK today. Our topic is living things. What do you mean by living things? Write today's date and CW. Living things means people, who people, or a thing which can breathe, feel, walk, talk, eat by itself, or do any activity by its own. For example, I, you, your mommy, papa, your neighbors, even plants, birds, animals are all living things. Why? Because they understand each and every movement. For example, आपको भूख लगी तो मम्मा को बोलते हो मुझे भूख लगी है खाना दो नाश्ता दो दूध दो पीने. When you come to school, I tell you open your English textbook. I show you this picture. Open a GK book. I show you this page. You open the correct book, correct? So we are called living things which have a certain movement. For example, plants grow. Plants भी move करते हैं ना? Plants से हमें हवा मिलती है. जब हवा तेज हवा आती है या धीमी हवा आती है, तो plants अपना अपने leaves को move करते हैं. And they breathe air. They breathe out air. जब वो breathe air करते हैं, वो क्या करते हैं? गंदा जो हवा रहता है. गंदा जो फॉर्म हवा का फॉर्म रहता है उसको बोलते हैं कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. वो अपने शरीर में लेते हैं और जब वो बाहर हवा छोड़ते हैं उसे स्वच्छ करके छोड़ते हैं प्लांट्स. एक्चुअली फ्रेश एयर दे लीव दैट इज कॉल्ड ऑक्सीजन. दैट ऑक्सीजन वी ब्रीद. सो वी आर ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स. ओके. प्लांट्स एनिमल्स एंड पीपल आर लिविंग थिंग्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज उनको खाना चाहिए, पीने के लिए पानी चाहिए एंड हम लोग ग्रो होते हैं स्टेप बाय स्टेप. आप अपने एज के हिसाब से, हाइट के हिसाब से ग्रो होते. लास्ट ईयर आप एलकेजी में थे, इस बार कैसे हुआ है आप यूकेजी में आए, तो आप बड़े हो गए. आप मोटे हुए, कोई पतले हुए हैं, किसी का हाइट बढ़ा है कि नहीं. देन हम लोग सब एक साथ रहते हैं एक घर में. मम्मी पापा दादा दादी नाना नानी चाचा चाची ऐसे हमारे फैमिलीज है. वी सिट टुगेदर, वी लिव टुगेदर. हमें क्या चाहिए? ग्रो होने के लिए खाना चाहिए, सांस लेने के लिए हवा चाहिए, फिर हमें पानी चाहिए, बराबर. So living things are things, or living things are people and animals, birds, or things you can say, which can do a certain activity by their own. Okay? हम खुद अभी मैं क्लास ले रही हूँ तो मैं खुद होके बुक खोलती हूँ. I tell you open the GK book. आप अपने बैग में से खुद होके बुक निकाल लो, बराबर. When you are hungry, you ask for food. When you are thirsty, you drink water. When you want to play, you tell your mama and you go out to play. Is that clear? You do some of the other activity, correct? So you all are called living things. See here, there are some living things. There's a baby cat grows up to a big cat. A baby plant grows up to a tree. You from childhood, you were a baby, small baby when you were born. You were just this much, and now you've grown so big. Barabar. From 1 year, 2 year, grown up like that. Okay, so you are called living things. जो सांस ले सकते हैं, जिन्हें खाना चाहिए या क्या पानी चाहिए पीने को, जो हर एक एक्टिविटी खुद होके करते हैं, उनको क्या बोलते हैं? लिविंग थिंग्स. ओके. नेक्स्ट नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स. टर्न द पेज टू पेज नंबर 100. आफ्टर लिविंग थिंग्स द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स? चीजें जो कुछ काम नहीं करती खुद होके. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, टेबल, चेयर, ब्लैक बोर्ड, डस्टर, इरेजर, योर स्कूल बैग, रिमोट, टीवी, वो सब नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स है. क्यों? आपके जैसे सांस नहीं लेती है. आप और मेरे जैसे एनिमल्स या प्लांट जैसे, प्लांट के जैसे सांस नहीं लेती है, खाना नहीं खाती है, फिर पानी नहीं पीती है. वो बढ़ती है क्या साइज में? नहीं. टीवी का साइज उतना ही होता है, फ्रिज का साइज उतना ही होता है, आपके कंपस बॉक्स, रिमोट, कार, वो जब तक हम मूव नहीं करते तब तक एक जगह से उठ के हिलते नहीं है. बट वेयर हैज लिविंग थिंग्स लाइक यू, मी, एनिमल्स, प्लांट्स, बर्ड्स, वो अपना खुद होके चल सकते हैं, अपना काम खुद कर सकते हैं. मैं अगर आपको बोलती हूँ यहाँ से उठ के वहाँ बैठो, तो यू मूव, बट मैं टेबल को बोलूंगी तो टेबल मिलता है क्या? नहीं, हमें खुद होके उठाना पड़ता है, चेयर खुद होके उठाना पड़ता है। जो चीजें खुद होके कुछ काम करती नहीं है उनको बोलते हैं नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स, और जो चीजें खुद होके काम करती है, सांस लेती है, खाना खाती है, उसको बोलते हैं लिविंग थिंग्स। ओके, सो नाउ पेज नंबर 101 इज योर होमवर्क। What they have given, look at the picture, color green for living things and orange and yellow for non-living things. जो भी living things है उनको circle में green करना है. For example, this boy, sorry, this stump. Stump is a non-living thing, तो उसको yellow करना है. ये आदमी living thing है ना, move कर रहा है, खाना खा रहा है, चलता है, सांस लेता है, living thing, तो इसको क्या करना है? Green करना है. Okay? So page number 101 is your homework. After that, living things and non-living things are related एक और topic है, that is natural and man-made. There are some which are natural, that is grown by God. Things that are grown by God or things that have been created by God, not grown by God, created, जो भगवान ने किए और जो इंसानों ने किए उसको बोलते हैं man-made, इंसानी चीजें. Man-made मतलब इंसानी चीजें, और जो भगवान ने बनाए हैं चीजों को उनको बोलते हैं natural. For example, हम natural being है because God has created us. Then animals, आपने animals बनाए, मैंने बनाए, नहीं, आपके मम्मी पापा ने बनाए, नहीं, तो these are all natural. River is a natural thing, roads are natural things, okay, flowers are natural things. एक flower का झाड़ pluck करके हम पेड़ पौधों में लगाते हैं, वो क्या बनता है? वो भी natural, because पहले एक झाड़ बना रहता है. Okay, so जो भी चीजें गॉड ने क्रिएट की हुई है उनको क्या बोलते हैं? नेचुरल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, स्काई, ट्रीज, सन, मून, स्टार्स, ये हमने नहीं बनाए हैं. ओके, ये सारी क्या चीजें हैं? फ्लावर्स, ट्रीज, रिवर, पॉन्ड, लेक, ये सारी क्या चीजें हैं? भगवान ने बनाए, दैट इज नेचुरली, खुद होके हमें दिखाई देती है. ओके, और इंसानों ने क्या बनाया? टेबल, चेयर, फिर कार, साइकिल, फिर क्या बनाया हमने? घर बनाया, गार्डन बनाया, ग्राउंड बनाया, ये सारे क्या है? इंसानी चीजें हैं. नाउ योर होमवर्क इज इन योर इंग्लिश नोटबुक ओनली. ओके, योर होमवर्क विल बी, यू हैव टू टेक योर मम्माज हेल्प एंड अराउंड 10 to 15 नेचुरल थिंग्स यू हैव टू राइट डाउन एंड 10 to 15 मैन मेड थिंग्स यू हैव टू राइट डाउन. ओके, व्हाट इज योर जीके होमवर्क? In your English notebook, write topic as natural and man-made, 10 to 15 things which are being created by nature or natural and 10 to 15 items by man-made. You have to write them. And page number 104 of your GK textbook is your homework. What is your GK homework today? Page number 104 and 101. And in your English notebook, GK topic is natural and man-made, a 10 to 15 items each you have to write, and this is your one-time writing composition. Okay, thank you.